We often flee to books, movies, myths, and legends in search of the strange and unnatural. But sometimes the strange and unnatural is right here in the real world, if only we dig a little deeper. From a never-ending storm to tornadoes made of fire, in this Sci-Fi, we do the digging for you and bring you five strange natural phenomena and explain why they occur. This planet may be more interesting than it is given credit for, so for the curious and the lovers of the strange, this episode is for you. Enjoy. Number 5. The Blue People of Kentucky. Also known as the Blue Fugates, the Blue People were exactly that, the Blue Family. The origins of this family date back to the early 1820s, when a Frenchman named Martin Fugate relocated to the town of Hazard, Kentucky. As with much of Kentucky, the town was quite remote, with not many people taking up residence within the borders of the community or even close by. This resulted in a lot of consanguinity within marriages. Essentially, this means many of the residents of the town were from the same bloodline as their spouse. Martin's eventual wife, Elizabeth Smith, happened to be a carrier of a recessive gene known as MET-H. As it happened, this was also a gene carried by another family close by which the Fugates would end up intermarried with. This resulted in many of the descendants of the family to suffer from the disease. With the double dose of the gene, many of the children were affected. For a long time, no one actually knew the cause of the blue skin, and they were okay with that. The family members usually lived to their 80s or 90s with no sign of serious disease apart from the normal occurring diseases. Locally, they were known as the Blue People. Further out, the word traveled and they were often referred to as the Blue People of Troublesome Creek, after a nearby creek. The word eventually made it to the ears of a young hematologist named Madison Kaywin. Madison made his way out to the town and discovered the family was plagued by the recessive gene. The disease, medically known as methemoglobinemia, is caused by elevated levels of methemoglobin in the blood. In summary, it results in a reduced ability of the red blood cell to release oxygen to tissues. This is what causes the blue tint in the skin. The gene was passed down through the isolated family, with many of the Fugates and associated family sporting the blue skin that they are now famous for. The rare blood disease has trickled out of the bloodline, and due to the remoteness of the family, the gene wasn't able to spread around much further than the Fugates. However, there are still other cases. The last known descendant of the family to experience the disease is a man named Benji Stacy. When Stacy was born, the doctors were immediately concerned with the color of his skin and rushed him to specialists. Not long after, his grandmother revealed her grandmother was a Fugate who was affected by the gene. This was in 1975. Benji's blue skin eventually went away in adulthood, and no other known relative is said to still have the blue skin. Number 4. The Everlasting Storm. This phenomenon is perhaps a gift from nature, as many sailors have made use of the constant lightning as a lighthouse. It has been known as the Lighthouse of Maracaibo, or more commonly known as the Catatumbo Lightning. It takes place in Venezuela, where the mouth of the Catatumbo River empties into Lake Maracaibo. And while the storm isn't exactly never-ending, as it does take some breaks, more often than not, the lightning is brightening the sky over the lake. 260 nights a year, 10 hours per day, and up to 280 times per hour to be exact. It originates from a mass of storm clouds that are about 1 kilometer high. The frequency of the lightning does vary somewhat throughout a year. Due to a drought, the storm actually stopped in January of 2010. There was fear the storm would be permanently finished, as it did not return from its hiatus until March of that year. The lightning has been going on for hundreds of years and has made its mark in many historical texts, including being mentioned in the epic poem La Dragon Tea by Lope de Vega, which refers to the Battle of San Juan, dating back to the late 1500s. The lightning is so well celebrated that it is depicted in the flag and the coat of arms of the state of Zulia. It is also mentioned in the state's anthem. So, what causes the phenomenon? Scientists believe the lightning is caused the same way any other lightning is caused, which means there is nothing strange about the lightning itself. The local topography and wind patterns are what make this area so interesting. The lake's basin, which is basically a dip in the Earth's surface, is closed in by mountains that trap the warm winds coming in from the Caribbean. Cool air flooding in from the Andes crash into the oppositional winds and force them up, which causes the air to condense and form into thunderclouds. This causes an average of 28 lightning strikes per minute across the area. This amount of energy could potentially power all the light bulbs in Latin America, and a Harvard study has also found that Catatumbo helps regenerate the ozone layer. Number 3. Gravity Hills. Gravity hills have also been referred to as magnetic hills, mystery hills, or even gravity roads. They are found in many places all over the world. At first glance, these hills look just as normal as any other, but it isn't until an object falls victim to the rules of gravity until the true nature and strangeness of the hill is observable. On these hills, things roll upward, as if completely defying gravity. A car in neutral would appear to be rolling up toward the top of the hill, and a ball rolling would appear to do the same. Some people believe this is caused by magnetic anomalies that pull any magnetic object toward the top of the hill, hence the name magnetic hill. This is not actually the correct explanation of what's going on here. What is going on is arguably much more interesting and more difficult to really wrap your mind around. Gravity hills are actually a naturally caused optical illusion. The illusion is caused by a number of factors, but most importantly, in all cases, the view of the proper horizon is hidden or mostly obstructed. This results in a lack of a reliable reference to judge the true slope of the hill. Objects around the hill, such as trees, may look to be pointing straight in the sky when actually they're leaning. Other objects that are unreliable may also add to the effect. As a result, the hill's slope appears to be a different direction than it actually is. A similar technique has also been used to create artificial optical illusions of the same style. For example, the Ames room. The Ames room was invented in 1946 by ophthalmologist Adalbert Ames Jr. and constructed the following year. When looking through a peephole, one can observe what looks like a normal room, but when moving an object or a person from one end to the other, the person or object appears to grow in size. Again, this is due to the misinterpretation of the line of the horizon. The design of the Ames room has been used for many purposes, but perhaps one of the most famous applications is in the Lord of the Rings films to create the effect of different sizes between different beings, such as between Gandalf and Frodo. Number 2, the door to hell. The door to hell is also referred to as the Darvaza gas crater, which would be a more literal take on the spot. The door is actually a crater in a desert near the village of Darwiz, Turkmenistan, that holds a fire that has been burning since 1971. The crater is 69 meters wide and 30 meters deep. In 1971, a team of Soviet scientists determined the area was a substantial oil field site. Not long after the engineers began constructing a drilling rig, it was discovered that there was a natural gas pocket below the surface. Due to this, the ground beneath the rig collapsed into the crater, burying the equipment. Concerned the crater would release poisonous gas to nearby towns, scientists decided it would be best to set the area on fire and burn it. Originally, it was thought the crater would burn for only a couple of weeks, but to their surprise, 47 years later, the crater continues to burn. In 2013, the president of Turkmenistan declared the area a natural reserve. Around the world, there are other instances where fires continuously burn due to the natural elements, with many of them also being human-started. Another example is in the ghost town of Centralia, Pennsylvania. In this case, a mine fire started in an attempt to burn some of the town's landfill site, which was a former coal strip mine. The town supposedly had volunteer firefighters start a controlled fire on the spot, but against their predictions, the fire never went out, and instead continued to grow, causing more holes in the ground around the town. The town originally tried to hide the origins of the fire, stating it had an unknown origin during a period of unusually hot weather. Due to lethal carbon monoxide levels and other dangers from the fire, the town was evacuated and now only exists as a ghost town that continues to burn. It is estimated that the fire will persist for at least 250 more years. Number 1. Fire tornadoes. Continuing the theme of fire and also the theme of storms, fire tornadoes, also known as fire whirls or fire devils, are large spinning gusts of fire that form a tornado appearance. Due to the fact these whirls do not stem from a storm cloud, they cannot technically be classified as a tornado. However, on January 18th of 2003, Australia's capital city, Canberra, experienced an actual tornado that was produced as a result of a strong wildfire. This was the first time a tornado caused by a wildfire was documented. The storm was so strong it was classified as a supercell thunderstorm, and due to the strength, a tornado spawned within the fire. Fire whirls have been reported as recently as 2016, when a few spawned in Missouri. The fire chief told news outlets he had never seen anything like it in his 39-year career. He was also quoted saying, "It was pretty cool." While on a small scale, these can be quite interesting to watch, on a larger scale, they are incredibly destructive. A great example of this would be the one that occurred during the 1923 Great Kanto earthquake in Japan. During the unexpected earthquake, massive fires broke out all over, causing multiple firestorms across many cities. The most devastating of these was the fire tornado that whipped across a small area in downtown Tokyo. In incredibly unfortunate circumstances, about 38,000 people were taking shelter in that location after the earthquake hit, when the fire and tornado whipped through. Nearly everyone was killed, and the fire was unable to be put out for about 2 days. Thanks for checking out this Sci-Five. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out my last video, 5 Questions and Answers on Terraforming Mars. And be sure to stay tuned for future Sci-Fives on all things science and science fiction. As well, the new Sci-Fives blog is now live. There, you can check out the blog post forms of all of the Sci-Five videos and get early access to new content. The link is below.